Okay, welcome to part 3 of the series of videos for BFD and MAC derivatives portion. Let us start the exam question. The exam question says Junaid Limited is in the process of setting up a plant for production of LED lights. The land for the plant was purchased at a cost of 100 million, whereas the plant and its installation will cost 250 million. Therefore, the total cost capitalized in PPE is 350,000, which should actually be depreciated over the number of years or any reasonable basis. The annual capacity of the plant is 1.5 million LEDs. Now you can produce 1.5 million LEDs in a single year. We are not provided with the life of the plant to depreciate this value. We are also not provided with number of LEDs the plant will actually manufacture throughout its life. Therefore, it is not actually possible to calculate the depreciation. We have to ignore it. In exams, I must write a note that although there is a depreciation expense which I have ignored, or secondly, I can reasonably say that since I was given fixed overheads value in point number 6, this amount may actually include the amount of depreciation. So moving on, it says that technical and commercial departments of the company have forwarded the following information. This information is available with you, and the point number 1 is about plant would operate in a single shift of 8 hours for 25 days per month. So this does not have any cost information in it. Point number two says the cost of raw material for the LEDs is estimated at 40 per unit, and since it is per unit, it is a variable cost. We have identified our first variable cost, which is rupees 40. Point number 3 says that the LED holder will cost 25 rupees per unit. It is expected that 4% holders will be defective. Whatever I buy, as many units I buy, 4% of those units will actually be defective and will have to be sold in scrap for rupees 2 per unit. So let's take an example of 100 units. Let's say I purchase 100 units for 25 rupees each. This will make it 2500. The question says whatever you purchase, 4% of them are defective. So actually, when I purchased 100, 4 were defective, which I disposed of at an scrap value of 2 and which realized rupees 8. So effectively, when I bought 100 holders, I was left behind with only 96 holders, which had a net cost of 2492. Now you can say that on an average, one LED had a holder which costs us 25.96. 2492 divided by 96 is 25.96. So this is also a variable cost, and therefore I will add 25.96 over here. Point number 4 says average direct labor time will be 3 minutes per unit. Now, one unit will need 3 minutes to get ready. Labor will consist of 32 workers who will be hired on a permanent basis. Laborers are hired on a permanent basis. By permanent basis, it implies that the labor cost is a fixed cost. Since even if laborers produce anything or they do not, I have to pay them, irrespective of whether I have work or not. They are paid a salary of 20,000 per month, and other benefits and perquisites will be 15% of the salary. So if I calculate annual value, I will say that I have to pay 20,000 to each worker. 15% bonuses are to be paid, therefore multiplying it by 1.15. There are 32 workers and there are 12 months in a year. So my total labor cost for one single year is 883200. and since they are hired on permanent basis, I have to pay laborers this amount irrespective of whether they produce anything, they work or they do not work. Therefore, this is my fixed cost. This is not dependent on number of units, which is 8, 8, 3, 2, 000. Point number 5 says that the variable overheads are estimated at 480 rupees per labor hour. And in point number 4, I noted that each unit takes 3 minutes. Therefore, I can say that this is a variable cost, which is 480 divided by 60 multiplied by 3. For each unit, the variable overheads cost amount that I have to pay is actually 480 divided by 60 is 8, 8 into 3 is 24. Therefore, this is one more variable cost. And in point number 6, it says that fixed overheads are estimated at 3.8 million per month on annual basis. I will multiply it by 12, which will be 3800000 multiplied by 12, which is 45.6 million. So my total fixed cost will be 8832000 and 4560000, which is in total 54432000. So my cost function will be, let me total this. 40 plus 25.96 plus 24 is 89.96. Therefore, my cost function will be a fixed cost of 54432000 plus 89.96. This is variable cost per unit multiplied by number of units. Moving on with the question, it says that the following information is based on a market survey which was conducted recently. And the market survey is that the current market price of an LED is rupees 180 per unit. It is estimated that the company can annually sell 1 to 40 000 units at the above price. Currently you are charging this price and currently you can sell this much units. It further says, however, the demand is price sensitive. The demand is price sensitive means that if you increase price, demand will decrease, and if you decrease price, demand will increase. The basic economics concept. The relationship between quantity demanded, X, and sales price can be expressed as under. This is your price function or this is your demand function, as we discussed in previous two parts. Therefore, my revenue function will be price function into number of units or quantity, which will be 273 minus 0.000075X. multiplied by X, and this will be 273x minus 0.000075x square. So the question says, determine the optimum selling price. I have to calculate selling price which will maximize the company's profitability for the first year of operations and calculate the optimum profit. As discussed in previous videos, we can solve this question by two methods. Either marginal revenue is equals to marginal cost or marginal profit is equals to zero. Both of these conditions will give you same answer. Let us solve this by this first method. First method says that marginal revenue should be equal to marginal cost. Now to solve this, I know that my revenue function is 273x minus 0.000075x square. Therefore, my marginal revenue function would be 273 minus 0.000075 into 2 is 0.00015x. And I know that my cost function is 54432000 plus 89.96x. Therefore, my marginal cost function is 89.96, and therefore when marginal revenue is equals to marginal cost, 273 minus 0.00015x is equals to 89.96, x will be equal to 89.96 minus 273 divided by 0.00015, which is 1220266. My profit will be maximized if I sell 1220266 units. And if my profit will maximize at these many units, the question's first requirement was to calculate the optimum selling price. Sales price function is given in question, and sales price function says that 273 minus 0.000075x. If I put the maximum profit units in this function, which is 1220266, my sales price would be 0.00075 into 1220266, 273 minus answer. Somewhere around 181.4. This is my answer to first part. The second part says, which would maximize the company's profitability for the first year of operations and calculate the optimum profit, optimum or maximum profit. Well, for maximum profit, I am not solving it, I am just writing the function. Profit is equals to revenue minus cost. So what you will do is write the revenue function, subtract the cost function. When you get the profit function, put x is equals to 1220266, and your final answer for profit value would be 57 million. Thank you for watching all three videos. Hope these three videos were helpful for BFD and MAC students to tackle the derivative question if the examiner asks the question again. It was last tested in summer 2015 exam. Thank you.